Mate, look at it. It's literally just peeling off, mate.
G'day, guys. So if you're into 4WD driving, getting a snorkel fitted to your car is pretty much cheap insurance, because if you don't have one, you could pretty much get water into your engine, you can hydrolock your engine, and you can do all sorts of damage and bend all sorts of stuff in your engine. So with your standard kind of airbox, it normally just ends up coming out into the guard, so any water that's forced up into there can go straight in. So having a snorkel is very important, but another thing is having a snorkel that's well installed. And I've just found out that mine isn't. So this snorkel was already on the car when I bought it, pretty much. And you know, you just kind of assume that it's all gonna be installed properly, right? And I've got to say that this is a genuine Mazda snorkel, so it's quite likely that Mazda actually installed this themselves, because they also installed the Mazda UHF radio in the car as well. But check this out. All right, guys, so, oh mate, where am I? Alrighty, guys, so this pipe here is what goes to the outside of the car, to the ram head, and then this bit here goes down to the airbox. So this is two separate pieces, and since there's a join, you can pretty much stick your finger into here, and when you turn the car on, you can actually hear the sucking as well. So if you got stuck in a bog hole and you were just stationary, you could have water just rushing into here, and then pretty much bye-bye engine. So that's not very good at all. So yeah, like, that could quite easily stuff up my engine. So I'm going up to Carrajini next week. So we're just having a cyclone through the top end of the Pilbara at the moment. So there could be a lot of water around. So I kind of want to fix this before I head up. And Justin's going to do all the work for me, aren't you?
Sounds good. Time for Smoko, I reckon.
Time for Smoko. Hasn't even done anything. Tell you, these kids these days. Can you watch the paint, mate?
She's a bit dirty.
Good silicon seal in there, eh, bro?
Yeah, there's a little.
Oh, mate!
There's a bit there.
Oh, that's classic.
Oh, well, look at that. Look at that. That is a picture. It's like curved right in.
So you can see how curved that is. There is no way that would have stopped water going in the sides in between. That sucks, hey? Like, that is such a shoddy snorkel design. Either way, like, if you went into water, you couldn't rely on that at all. And that silicon is rubbish anyway, like, look at it.
And that's what goes into your airbox, so it's, the water line is only as high as the end of your airbox, really.
Yeah, I wouldn't
wouldn't be putting faith in it.
Mate, look at it, it's literally just peeling off, mate, look at that.
Well, it looks like I might be staying another night, mate, I can't drive home.
It's alright, we got roof and gutter silicon.
That'll do. Alrighty, guys, so I've just... Why do I always say alrighty? I feel like I just need to stop saying it, because I say it every second sentence. What do I say instead, though?
Just go straight into it. Just right. Remove the airbox.
Just remove the airbox, and so that pretty much meets up with that. That's how it all kind of goes together. And this part's siliconed on. What kind of silicon did they use, dude? Like,
it just... It was silicon.
They stuck it to a sticker.
And this is why you can't trust dealerships with your 4WD driver, I reckon, because it's just like, this is just ridiculous. Like, I could have drowned my car so easily if I didn't get around to fixing this. So pretty much the plan is to clean this all up and put it all back together. And because that pipe is so bent in at the top there, we're probably going to make two spaces and stick them in there to separate it, to keep it a nice consistent width. So that way, when we silicon this and chuck it up in there, we should have a nice good seal. And yeah, hopefully I won't ever bust the engine in a deep water crossing. The other thing is, like, this really is...
That wasn't a solid fit.
This is not a nice fit at all. Like, no. That is just, like, so floppy. Check out that gap. That is just ridiculous. That's insane. So I've just pretty much cleaned off all the old silicon off all of the pipes and just given them a good wash down so they're all clean. So I'm gonna leave them in the sun for a bit to dry. Justin's just cutting out the spaces for the bit up here in the guard. So as far as the silicon that I'm gonna use... As far as the silicon goes that I'm going to use to join all the pipes together, I'm going to use roof and gutter silicon, mainly because that's all we got, but I pretty much use roof and gutter silicon for everything. It's just such a handy, tough silicon, UV resistant also, 25-year guarantee, so it's pretty good. And another thing, because it's on the other side of the air filter, it's not the engine side of the air filter, it doesn't really matter, as far as I'm aware, whether it's sensor-safe silicon or not. So Justin kindly made me this spacer here. So it's just a piece of flat aluminium, and I'll show you where that's gonna go.
Thanks, by the way, mate.
No worries.
Good job.
So as you can see, this bit of pipe's like really pushed together. Maybe the hole for the actual piece of pipe was cut too small, maybe not, but anyway, this bit of metal here is just gonna separate it for us so that when we silicon around it, it's gonna have a nice solid seal. And we're also just gonna run a bead of silicon in here just to try and stop this ever moving, just in case of corrugations and the like. So that's the rough plan, and I reckon it should work really, really well. Massive thanks to Justin for coming up with that legendary idea. Good job, bro.
Oh, mate, not TIG welding anymore.
Looks like dog slag, this bloke.
Dog slag, mate. Perfection.
Look at that, guys, perfection. All right, let's chuck this airbox back in. All right, awesome. It's not pretty, but it'll do. All right, what do you reckon, Justin? Is that gonna do?
Safe as hell.
If my car ever dies in a water crossing, mate.
Nah, there's no warranty at the moment. You leave the garage.
Yeah, because you don't want to push it up too far and push your silicon away.
Yep, good there?
Yep, should be. Would you be able to grab the 10 mil for us? Oh, mate, is that a long enough extension or what?
You don't want your hand to hit the paintwork.
Oh, that's right, that's what you were doing earlier. So there you go, it's in, guys, it's in. And hopefully it's a bit better sealed, but what I'm also gonna do is just try and get some silicone on my finger and just run my finger along the edges up here and here, just to give me the best possible chance of a good watertight seal that I can get. So everything's bolted back together. As the pipes went together, I put as much silicon as I could get to on the outside as well, so I'm pretty confident that there's a really good seal now. So if you already have a snorkel and you're not sure as to how well it was installed, one test you can do is to partially block your snorkel head. I wouldn't fully do it because then you can actually cause a leak to occur somewhere in the system, but just partially block it, and if you can hear sucking anywhere in the pipework, chances are you got air coming in somewhere that it shouldn't. So that's one little test that you can do. Otherwise, if you're getting a snorkel installed, ask questions. Ask them, do they fully seal the snorkel? Is it gonna be good for water crossings? Because you wanna have the confidence knowing that your engine's gonna get good dry air, because if it gets water, all sorts of bad things are gonna happen. The other thing, try and get a good quality snorkel, because personally, I was pretty disappointed with how this snorkel was put together. I reckon there could be a better design out there, because when you saw how much play there was in between those two fittings, it's kind of like, man, that's just not good. Like, you need so much silicone to feel that connection there. So just another thing to keep in mind. But thanks for watching, guys. I hope you guys learned something from this video, and we'll catch you guys in another one. Not that this thing ever gets stuck anyway, you know.
Oh, really?
Never get stuck, does it, Juggy?
It's no patrol, so we can't say never.
Seek adventure!